It's got to be one of these places. The arsonist's a bug sprayer. He must have worked at one of these joints.
Help you?
How many guys you have working here, Pop?
Who's asking, son?
It could be official or unofficial. Depends on how you want to play it.
You should get to a hospital, son. That arm of yours appears to be letting in daylight.
Save the pity for the other guys. They're the ones who need it. I'm looking for a big cowboy who works pest control. Does he work here?
We don't have anyone like that here.
You sure? I'm not the type of guy you want coming back.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Welcome to Nuclear. What can I do you for?
I work for the DA. I need to speak with an exterminator, big guy with a cowboy accent.
We have only three people work here, me and two Mexicans. They're both on the scrawny side.
Thanks for your help.
That's disgusting. Didn't you ever hear of germs?
I work for the DA. I'm looking for a big cowboy who does extermination. Anyone like that working here?
Well, I wouldn't want to get anyone into any trouble.
We could do this the hard way. An address?
Yeah. He lives in a bunkhouse on the remains of the old Rancho Rincon.
Thanks.
Cole, you made it.
What's this got to do with me, Rusty?
Dr. Fontaine, prominent shrink, dead in his patient's room. Spine snapped like a twig. The suspect is one of his mental patients.
I've met Fontaine.
His last patient was Elsa Lichtman, Cole. She's missing. Nurse said that she saw some big Boris Karloff type carry her out of here.
The best thing that you can do to help me, Rusty, is let me take a look around.
Sure thing, Cole. This way.
Looks like Fontaine has finally dispensed his last treatment.
Take your time. I'll give you and the doctor some privacy.
Fontaine was having the houses burned for Monroe. Monroe wasn't happy. People started dying and it attracted attention. He and the doctor lost control. So much for your foresight, Doctor.
Destroyed by a monster of your own creation, Dr. Fontaine. I've heard that story somewhere before.
Good doctor has been marking this map. Edgewood Grove, McCarthy Vista, Crescent Heights, Rancho Escondido. Do those names mean anything to you, Herschel?
Yeah. How come?
New houses all being built in the path of the freeway? Jack was wrong. It's not about insurance. It's about eminent domain.
What are you talking about, Cole?
The government reclaims the land in the path of the freeway and pays the improved value of the land with the new houses sitting on it.
What about the stiffs who paid their deposits?
Worst case, they get their money back. But the syndicate pockets millions on the improved value of the land.
So where does Jack's boss come into it?
He's the key. He carries the insurance. The insurance proves how much the houses are worth.
And they're worth nothing?
Firewood. All of them.
That's about as neat a scam as you can imagine. How are we going to prove any of this, Cole? Doctor's dead. Monroe nearly bled to death. If they get Jack...
We need the firebug. The Okie cowboy. Get him, get Elsa. Get him, get all of them. Guess nobody's home. Most guys bring home a 45 or an M1. This is pretty extreme. Quite a flock you got here, kid. I know those faces. Jesus Christ, I know every one of them. A strange obsession. The river tunnels. This guy's a tunnel rat. Oh my God, Ira. You poor backwards son of a bitch.
Peterson, I'm going to need some help. I've got Monroe, Fontaine, and all the others. It's all tied up nicely. It goes all the way to the top. Meet me at the LA River Tunnel entrance just north of the First Street Bridge in half an hour. Don't ask questions. Just be there. This is DA's investigator Jack Kelso. I have an urgent radio message for Detective Cole Phelps.
Go ahead, KGPL.
11K, see the man. A 207 just occurred on the spillway north of the First Street Bridge. DA's investigator Jack Kelso reports a kidnapping suspect outstanding in the LA River Tunnel system with a hostage. 11K, handle
Roger
code
that.
3.
The hell is Jack playing at? Like a suicide note. Half the LAPD will be down there hunting for us.
We need to get there first.
All units on all frequencies, stand by. Car 86 Adam is in pursuit of suspect vehicle heading southwest on Sunset Boulevard. Suspect vehicle belonging to Jack Kelso, described as a Navy Chevrolet Fleetline. License number 4, William 0286. Car 86 Adam is in pursuit.
I picked up his car. I'll need help to make it to the river.
That's Kelso's car.
All units, Chief Goro reports that the suspect is armed and extremely dangerous. Repeat, extremely dangerous. Suspect vehicle to be disabled immediately. If necessary, use of deadly force is authorized.
All units, suspect vehicle headed west on Fifth Street. Repeat, the Chevy Fleetline Navy Blue, westbound on Fifth Street.
All units, we have a new suspect vehicle. It is shop number 13516. Repeating, shop 13516 is a second suspect vehicle. Responding to a green Hudson Commodore. License 3-SAM-0102. Reported to be aiding suspect Jack Kelso. Use caution and continue pursuit. All units, stand by for further.
All units, suspect vehicle sighted heading northeast toward 3rd Street on the embankment between 3rd and 4th. All units, suspect vehicle now northbound on Los Angeles passing 2nd Street. Car 66 Adam, 77 Adam, go to 1st and Alameda.
Further to the second suspect vehicle, shop 13516. Chief Wall has authorized the use of deadly force. Repeat, use of deadly force is authorized in disabling both suspect vehicles.
Jesus Christ! How many cops do these guys own?
Who is this guy?
Peterson, assistant DA.
What's he doing?
He's here,
here
to cover our backs.
I'm going in there, Jack.
No one's trying to stop you. I found this at the ranch house. He's marked his routes. I'll go in here. Cole, you take the next entrance. Biggs, I need you to take the car and cover this spot here. I think that's his failsafe exit. Cole, he's one of ours.
What are you talking about?
Right where you are!
Got it?
Got it.
Peterson, you want to be DA? We'll earn your salt.
So, Kelso is your boy, Peterson? And working with Phelps? A handy lad, that Kelso.
Yes, he is, Chief.
You can't imagine what those two have uncovered. It could go all the way to the top. I hope you won't be implicated.
So, you're the new broom, Peterson?
Looks like it.
And you think he'll make it out of there alive?
I think he might. He's a difficult boy to get rid of.
All right, Peterson. I'm listening. What's your offer?
Want me? You got me.
You're pretty brave for a dead man.
God damn it! How long do you think you can hold out?
Soon as he pokes his head out, we step on it.
The water's rising. You can walk out of here or go out in the bus. Are you okay, Princess?
I felt better. He saved me from the doctor.
Hi, Tex. Do you remember me?
I'm not sure that I do. Have you come here to kill her?
Why would I do that, soldier?
Isn't that why you're all here?
I'm here to get her out.
Her. but not me. You haven't come for me.
No, not you. It ends here.
You were with the Sixth on Sugarloaf, weren't you?
I was.
And Naha?
Yes, I was.
You're Sergeant Jack Kelso, aren't you? Where's your uniform, Sarge?
At home in my locker, Hogaboom! War's over, soldier!
I know that, Sarge. I'm fighting a different kind of war. I fight for God now.
We all fight for God, Ira.
In our own ways. Not everybody knows it.
Elsa! Are you all right? Get away from her!
It's all right, Cole. He doesn't want to hurt her. Ira was with us on Okinawa.
What? You know this guy?
Don't you remember me, Lieutenant? I remember you.
No. No.
You ordered me to burn that cave, Lieutenant. That cave full of civilians. A hospital.
What is he talking about?
It was war. For God's sake, I can't be held responsible for everything that happened.
I don't blame you, Lieutenant. You helped me to help other people.
Ira lost his mind on Okinawa, Princess.
Sheldon asked the doctor to help me get it back.
The doctor helped me to find my path. And I helped him to a better life.
Elsa's going to leave now, Ira. She will be all right. You've helped her, too. Get her out of here. Biggs will help. His exit is nearby.
Jack, I need this guy to make the case.
Hasn't this poor bastard given you enough? Get out of here now!
For God's sake, Jack! What are you going to do?
Don't cry, miss. Sergeant Kelso has come to help ease my way. I was proud to serve with you, Jack.
Get out of here, Cole!
Gathered here to honor Detective Cole Phelps. Cole Phelps was the best kind of man.
Hear, hear.
A war hero who led his men with true valor and through his personal bravery achieved one of his country's highest honors. A cop wrongly accused who never lost his faith in the LAPD and the system.
Mine! You belittle his memory.
Elsa.
Get out of my way, Jack. You call yourself his friend.
A detective who fought to expose the evil corruption of the murderous Dr. Fontaine and the rapacious property tycoon, Leyland Monroe.
Go to her. Will you, Herschel?
A reformer.
You were never his friend,
Jack. Who recognized the need to remove the odd bad apple from a department made up of good men.
Herschel?
A man who never gave up.
Yeah, Jack.
Who continued to fight the good fight.
I think you knew that, Jack.
The fight that cost him his own life. A good husband. A good father. And may I say, a good friend.